أعزائي طلبة وطالبات الثانوية العامة، أهلا بكم في حلقة جديدة من حلقات برنامج مدرس على الهواء، الحلقة رقم 18. مساء الخير على كل طلابنا الأعزاء، مساء الخير على كل مدرسي اللغة الإنجليزية على مستوى الجمهورية اللي يتابعونا، واللي إحنا كالعادة مستنيين كل ملاحظاتهم حتى نرتقي ببرنامج وندنو من الكمال. هيكون في ضيفتنا النهاردة دكتورة أماني النجار، واللي هتشرح لنا اللغة الإنجليزية للمناهج البريطانية والمناهج الأمريكية. مساء الخير يا دكتور.
اهلا دكتور احمد، ازي حضرتك؟
شرفتينا وتشرفينا
ميرسي
كالعاده،
جدا يا مستر احمد.
وهنسيبك مع طلابك طبعا، دي الحلقه الاولى بالنسبه لنا للغه الانجليزيه بالنسبه للمناهج الامريكيه وبالنسبه للمناهج البريطانيه، فيا ريت تدينا نبذه كده عن الموضوع بالنسبه للطلاب في المرحله دي.
ان شاء الله النهارده يعني هنشتغل درس محوري هيمشي مع المناهج البريطانيه والمناهج الامريكيه، هنشتغل سنتنس اند فراجمنت. الدرس دوت يعني بيجي كتير جدا سواء في ريدنج او في رايتنج او في كومبريهنشنز، فالطلبه يعني لو مش فاهمينه كويس بيبقى في مشكله، هو مش عارف يقف هنا او يكمل الجمله او يعمل سيبريشن او ران اون، فهو مش فاهم بالظبط الجمله تقف فين واذا كانت هي جمله كامله او لا، فده اللي احنا عاوزين نشرحه النهارده ونبينه يعني للطلبه. هو بيتماشى مع كمان الطلبه في الدبلومه الامريكيه، سواء الناس اللي كانوا بياخدوا اس اي تي واتوقف في مصر الفتره يعني قدامنا لغايه شهر 6 ان شاء الله، او بالنسبه للطلبه اللي اوريدي امتحانهم بكره ربنا معاهم اللي هم اي سي تي، وبالتوفيق للجميع. فاحنا اخترنا درس يتماشى مع الاثنين، وتقريبا الجزئيه الجرامر والرايتنج في الاس اي تي هي يا جماعه في الاي سي تي، في اختلافات بسيطه جدا لكن يعني كمعيار محوري للامتحانين او من الناحيه الاكاديميه نفس التساوي. الاي سي تي هو الاس اي تي في القدرات المعينه اللي بيقصها للطالب نفسها، يعني الطالب الممتاز هنا هيجيب برضو سكور ممتاز جدا هنا،
تمام،
مش هيحصل اي اختلاف.
يعني احنا عرفنا من البيانات اللي موجوده عن حضرتك ان انت قعدتي درستي المناهج دي لمده 12 سنه في السعوديه.
درست 12 سنه في السعوديه، كنت بدرس في الجامعه، يعني هو مش المناهج دي قوي بس ريليتد يعني ليها علاقه،
حاجه لها علاقه بيها، تمام.
كنت بدرس سنتين، اول سنتين طبعا الكلام ده من 2008، انا عجوزه يا جماعه معلش، 2008 كنت في جامعه الامام محمد بن سعود، وبعدين بقى 2010 اتنقلت الى الملك سعود سنتين، تمام. بعد كده اتنقلت بقى لاحب الاماكن لقلبي جامعه الجوف في سكيكا، ويعني من هنا بشكر كمان زمايلي اللي هناك، كان في دكتوره ماضي ودكتور شاليني ساعدوني جدا، ويعني كانت احلى صحبه واحلى سنين عمر بصراحه.
طب بالنسبه للمناهج الاي جي والسات والامريكان بصفه عامه، اللي انا اعرفه ان كان في حصل ضجه الفتره اللي فاتت بخصوص
هو
تاجيل امتحانات وتسريبات وحاجات من هذا القبيل.
هقول لحضرتك ليه حصلت ضجه، لان احنا تعرضنا لهجوم شرس من ما يسمى مسربي الامتحانات. دي يعني تقريبا مافيا، الوزير الحمد لله قدر يعني يقفلها شوية. كان الامتحان بيسرب، فأنا كولي أمر طبعا ابني واخد درس ودروس غالية جدا في الأماكن دي، وسيبك كمان من اللود الفكري والمعنوي عليك كمدرس وعلى عليك كولي أمر، يجي يوم الامتحان بالليل يعني الطالب يا حرام يبقى امتحانه الصبح وعامل حسابه بقى انت خلاص بقى بتظبط حالك كده رايح امتحان، يا حرام يقول له ايه ستوب امتحانك اتلغى. طيب يعني ازاي تلغي لي امتحان يوميها الصبح؟ طب الغي لي قبلها باسبوع، الغي لي قبلها باثنين او عرفني. فالحمد لله الوزير يعني نجح في ان هو جاب يعني بالتعاون برضو مع منظمه امريكيه محترمه الاي سي تي، والامتحان تقريبا هو هو يعني الضجه اللي حاصله. ممكن الاس اي تي كانت الريدنج طويله شويه، طويله يعني كانت خمس قطع، وبتقيس قدرات خاصه يعني عندي في مثلا لوجيكال جاستيفيكيشنز ديت مش اي حد هيعرف يجيبها، كريتيكال اناليسز مش اي طالب بيجيبها، لا الاس اي تي كان مليان، لكن الاي سي تي اكبر شويه لكن بصوره مباشره اكتر، ماتش مور دايركت.
جميل.
يعني الرينج هنا اصعب شويه وعدد اسئله اقل، لا هنا اسهل شويه ودايركت شويه فعدد اسئله اطول.
جميل. حلقه موفقه ان شاء الله يا دكتور.
ربنا يخليك يا مستر احمد.
اتفضلي يا
مستر.
اتفضلي.
بوت يور بورد اند براكتس ماي فيفورت هوبي.
اوكي جو اهيد.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Today we are going to explain one of the most important lessons in grammar for both IG and American diploma students. It is entitled Sentence and Fragment. first let's we begin with a sentence. What's a sentence? What's a sentence? A sentence is one word or more than word that can stand as separate unit, meaningful structure. Mm-hmm. One student asks me one word. Yeah, I have one word sentence. I will begin with it. Mm-hmm. One word sentence is only one word that can stand as a meaningful structure. If I take care of the word. Meaningful structure means تركيبة كاملة. You don't mm-hmm. want to ask what, when, who. I have a lot of words that can stand alone as a separate word. Some are interrogative. Some declarative. Some nominative. Some are locative. Interrogative when you say who. Mm-hmm. Who give you a meaningful structure you are going to answer. Declarative when I'm saying me. Nominative, Jesse or Jean. Any name. Locative here and there. And the most famous one, imperative. I write it with another color. Stop. Stop, please. You have understood what I'm saying. Wait. Mm-hmm. Don't need, please wait. This is one word sentence. All of these are one word sentence. But not all sentences are very small like that. The criterion of being sentence or no, meaningful structure. What is the smallest unit of a sentence? Here, I will give you another kind. When I say birds fly, fish swim. Here, subject and verb, and they can stand alone. You don't want to ask me what will happen, who, when, where, why, you. No, you don't need to ask. Fish swim. Yeah, it's a fact. Fish swim indicate a fact, but still it's a meaningful structure, giving the same criterion. Meaningful structure is the criterion for sentence or some words, more than one word or more than word, that can stand alone as a complete meaningful structure. You don't want to ask when, where, how, what is the reason, stop. Mm-hmm. Fish swim, you don't need to say where, how, why, for what reason, no. Birds fly, the same. And we have the normal kind, Ahmed. All the students know this kind. Ahmed plays football, SVO. You must call it SVO. Subject, verb, object. This is the most common type of sentences, subject, verb, object. We have another group of words called the fragment. What is the difference between sentence and the fragment? Does it depend on the number of items or words used? No. The criterion is meaningful structure. When it says Ahmed lives next door. If we are going to count 1, 2, 3, 4 words and they stand as a meaningful structure, it indicates a meaning, give me a meaning. Ahmed lives next door. Subject, main verb, predicate. Mm-hmm. Here I want to say Ahmed who lives next door. Mm-hmm. You are going to ask me what happened to him. Mm-hmm. We added one element. Ahmed, the same. We added another word.
Who?
If we are going to count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
We need to complete the sentence here.
But here.
Complete the meaning.
Yeah, you want to know what happened. Mm-hmm. Traveled last night.
Yes.
Moved to another flat. Mm-hmm. Married another woman. Mm-hmm. Who knows? I have here two tell what happened to Ahmed who lives next door because here who make it not main verb. The verb here changed from main verb not became it is not a main verb Ahmed الذي يعيش but for the first sentence Ahmed lives next door Ahmed يعيش بجوارنا next door but here main verb who no the main verb it is not a proper main verb now we need to add main verb
to complete the meaning of the sentence
yeah married another woman all my students know this sentence Ahmed who lives next door married another woman here it has been completed now the tense the main verb here is not lived the main verb married the main verb now married yes. I will give you another example let me clean the board first Let it be cleaned as a whole for the first time. How can we build a sentence? Let me take an example, birds fly. Now it's a sentence, complete meaningful structure, it's a sentence. How can we build it? Some sentences are very long. How can a student build or make a sentence very large or how can he use his ability to write big sentences or large sentences? How? By rules. I can see here, white, birds fly. I will count here, one, two. Quick. I add two words, white, and quickly. White is an adjective describe a noun, birds. صفة اسمية. White, birds. And the fly is a verb. We need an adverb, quickly. بسرعة. Here the sentence became one, two, three, four items. Still I can add more. Here I added three prepositional phrases. I will add more. Three prepositional phrases. Here the sentence, verb, and subject were added. Adjective for the subject, noun. Noun takes an adjective to be described to that, white birds. And for the verb, I wrote quickly. I can write very quickly, relatively quickly, slightly quickly, extremely quickly. Adverb and adverb. Here I made extension by in the sky place from east to west another place but more much more specific during timing the months of autumn why still I will add I will count later on Here I added much more. We still, I will repeat it. White birds fly quickly in the sky from east to west during the months of autumn to reach a warmer shelter. Reason why why these actions
to reach our warmer shelter. Okay.
Yeah, to find a warmer shelter. Why? Before the arrival of severe winter, they are escaping from autumn, in autumn to reach a shelter before the severe winter. Why? In order, another prepositional phrase, in order to offer their chicks a better chance of life. Ended. Here I can stop at any place. I can stop here at any place. I can stop here. It will give a meaningful sentence. One, meaningful. Here. Here or here. Here we made one, two, three, four, five, six extensions. And anyone can be deleted. Here I can delete this. White birds fly quickly from east to west during the months of autumn to reach a warmer shelter before the arrival of severe winter in order to offer their chicks a better chance of life. I can delete anyone.
And it gives me a complete meaning.
Again, complete meaning. Any one of them. White birds fly quickly from in the sky from east to west during the months of autumn before the arrival of severe winter in order to offer their chicks a better chance of life. What do you want me to delete? Again, choose one, Mr.
In the sky?
I can delete in the sky, omitted that one. What else?
In order to offer their chicks?
I can, yeah.
Chance of life.
White birds fly quickly in the sky from east to west during the months of autumn to reach a warmer shelter before the arrival of severe winter. Okay, till here. All these are called non-essential elements. All the elements I have added, one, two, three, four, five, six, are non-essential elements. We have another lesson, essential and non-essential. We'll take it in another time. Essential can be deleted without any effect on the whole meaning. The meaning is still correct, proper. It is a meaningful structure. White birds fly. The only word I can omit or delete and no sentence will be found, fly. White birds quickly and birds.
Doesn't make a sense.
If I won't say, white fly quickly. But still I can say, delete white. And I can say, and I can delete quickly. Birds fly in the sky. The main two elements here are birds and fly. They can never be deleted because the main subject and the main verb are considered to be the two most essential elements of meaningful structure. We agreed that meaningful structure. Sentence. Meaningful structure, we agreed that the criterion of a sentence is to give you a meaningful structure. Either one word, stop, wait, who, me, declarative, or more than one word. If you are going to comment without before deleting, it will be 35 words. We begin from two, reach it into 35 words. And still, it's only one mean sentence. يعني كل دي جملة واحدة مش تقدر تقولي إنها جملتين. تعالي we are going to count. One mean sentence. Fragment بقى نرجع ليه. We are going to move to fragment. Two minutes for fragments. Then we have to explain some items. Fragment means a structure that can't stand alone as a meaningful unit. Like when I'm saying, some element might be wrong or some element might be not in its place. Ahmed being the best, here it's a fragment. I have to say is. When I want to say being, Ahmed being the best student in class, all the teachers love him. I have to complete to make it sentence. Okay?
Okay. Okay, have a seat.
Okay. ممكن نسرح.
كده محتاجين نشوف الأسئلة مع بعض.
يا ريت نشوف بقى الأسئلة كده.
يا ريت نستأذن المخرج بتاعنا الجميل يجيب لنا الجزء بتاع الإكسرسايزز اللي الدكتورة أماني مجهزاه. بيج نمبر 1. Okay, go ahead.
For each statement below, circle sentence if it can stand alone. The main criterion, stand alone, give you a meaningful structure. As an independent sentence, she doesn't need dependent part to support it. Dependent sentence and fragment if it cannot stand alone. If it cannot stand alone, you have to add another element. You have to add another element. Number one. Louis Armstrong was one of the greatest jazz musicians of the 20th century. We have to look for main subject and main verb. Main subject and main verb. Mm-hmm. Here you have Louis Armstrong and the main verb was. Mm-hmm. It's a meaningful structure. Here it's a complete sentence. Mm-hmm. We don't want to add any element.
It's okay.
Moving to number two, he was one of the greatest jazz musicians of the 20th century. He or Louis Armstrong still subject, either noun or pronoun. I have seven pronouns, I, he, she, it, you, we, and they. Seven subject pronouns. Mm-hmm. Here, equivalent for Louis Armstrong, I'd give it correct and meaningful structure. It is a complete sentence. Mm-hmm. Number three, Louis Armstrong was one of the greatest jazz musicians of the 20th century. It's a complete meaningful structure. No, it's a here, it's a fragment because I added who. If I want to say it as a sentence, I should delete who. Louis Armstrong was one of the greatest jazz musicians of the 20th century. Here it's a fragment. Mm-hmm. Another way to make it sentence, died at the age of 75. Louis Armstrong, who was mm-hmm. one of the greatest jazz musicians of the 20th century, يعني لويس أرمسترونج الذي كان أحد أهم العازفين في موسيقى الجاز في القرن العشرين died at the age of 75 or 71 توفاه الله في العام 71 أو 75 here died is a main verb أنا عندي الجملة الغلطة فيها ما عنديش main verb واحد يقول لي يا ميس عندك هو أقول له لا هو was هو موتتها يبقى أنا عندي was I have to add another
page number two.
Page number two, Louis Armstrong, who was one of the greatest jazz musicians of the 20th century. Till now, it's a fragment. Was a vocalist. Was a vocalist. Main verb. It became a sentence, as well as a trumpet player. Vocalist, خليتها لي جملة. يعني بعد كده كل ده صحيح. Because when we add sentence to fragment, it is still a sentence. Sentence plus fragment, it remains a sentence. Fragment plus fragment plus fragment plus fragment. Endless fragments make it fragment. Today, number five, he is considered one of the greatest jazz musicians of the 20th century. He is considered passive structure. People consider him still, it's a main verb, but conjugated and passive structure, it's a sentence. Number six, he is now considered one of the greatest jazz musicians of the 20th century. He is considered main verb. A sentence.
Page number three.
Because of his trumpet skills, Louis Armstrong is considered one of the greatest jazz musicians of the 20th century. Because of his greatest skill, the first part is a fragment, but is considered the main verb. It makes it complete meaningful structure. Here it's a complete sentence. Number eight, although he was one of the best trumpet player of his generation. What happened? He didn't get fame in his lifetime. If mm-hmm. I'm going to complete with a main verb, mm-hmm. he didn't get fame.
Okay.
Number nine, many people considering. This is one of the most important elements. It always comes in the exam like that, considering, because your eyes won't see it from the first glance. Considering, here I have to say, are considering. Many people are considering, or many people consider, much more better. Many people consider. Here it's a fragment because of the ing added to the main verb consider. Many people considering him, or many people considering Louis Armstrong, the greatest jazz musician of all the time, were 40. لو انا عايزه اكمل لازم احط مين فيرب وير فوتي كانوا على خطا. نمبر 10 ميني كونسيدر هيم ذا جريتست جاز ميوزيشن اوف اول تايم. ميني مين سبجكت كونسيدر فيرب ات از جوينت تو بي ا كومبليت مينينج
بيج نمبر 4
سنتنس سمول سنتنس بات ستيل اتس مينينج فول. ميني اوف هوم many of whom it is not a subject. What happened? Many of whom consider him the greatest jazz musician of all time were Americans. Here I have to complete with a meaningful sentence with a main verb. Many of whom consider him the greatest jazz musician of all time were Americans. Number 12, having, not have, having shown an unusual gift for music nearly in his childhood, Louis Armstrong was born in New Orleans on August 4, 1901, it's still fragment. All these elements fragment because I don't have main verb. Look at it, having. No main verb. Who was born? I have to delete who, it will be a sentence. Or to complete having shown an unusual gift for music early in his childhood, Louis Armstrong, who was born in New Orleans on August 4, went on the main verb here, number 13, completed with main verb, went on to become one of the greatest jazz musician of the 20th century. Number 12 is fragment. Number 13, the main sentence, because of the most important element, went on, the main verb.
Page number 5.
Yeah. Moreover, number 14, moreover, Armstrong, whose band much of his early life in poverty, went on to become one of the greatest jazz musicians of the 20th century. Went on, main verb, it's a sentence. 15, nicknamed Satchmo, Louis Armstrong, who was born in New Orleans on August 4, grew up. The main verb, grew up. I want to complete, it's a main sentence, to become one of the greatest jazz musicians. It's a complete sentence because once you saw the main verb, it's a complete sentence.
Okay, page number 6.
Page number 6, yes. Label each of the following phrases as either sentence or frag. Rewrite frag as a sentence. We have two elements. We are going to label it's a frag or a sentence. And when it is a frag, you have to complete it as a sentence, but in one condition, either by adding or eliminating only one element, one word only. Since 29, physicists having been intrigued by possible evidence of dark matter in the center of the Milky Way galaxy. Here I have to delete ing and add e, have, to make it as a main verb, have been. Number 2, it's a fragment, and when we deleted ing, it turned into a main sentence. When they catch sight of their prey and falcon, any and run on sentence, I have to eliminate and to make it a sentence. And the falcon drop into sweep. Here, when they catch sight of their prey, falcon drop, it will become main sentence. Number 3, each is bring students who here should be eliminated because it's a fragment. In order to make it a sentence, we have to delete who gather from around the world for the first robotic competition, an experience that can change lives. I have to delete who on.
Page number 7, yes.
Page number 7, number 4, many forms of mediation, a practice that has been examined by researchers over the last several decades and have been. I have to delete and, the main verb have been. Mm-hmm. Number 5, they enjoy national popularity with the average person in the United States consuming over 25 pounds of them each year. It's a main sentence. We don't need to add or delete. It's correct meaningful structure. Finding number 6, finding from one recent study about maturity suggesting. Suggest here is a main verb. I have to eliminate ing. I have to eliminate the ing. Number 7, Chicago's metropolitan area, sometimes called Chicagoland, which? Chicago, I have to delete which. Mm-hmm. Which is home, no which here, to make it as a main verb.
Yeah, page number 8.
Page number yes. 8. She began adding elements of gossip. Began adding. she began adding sentence. She began adding, I won't complete, but it is a mean sentence. She began, I can read, she began adding elements of gospel music into her songs. In early 1961, releasing her first gospel-influenced album later last year. أنا المعيار عندي الكريتيريا مين verb and mean subject. Won't waste your time. The Great Lake being. Here being is not a mean verb. I have to say the Great Lakes were or are because there is no reference to the tense, either present or past. The Great Lakes are a major highway of transportation, or the Great Way was were a major highway for transportation, either are or were. The last sentence, today, graduates of avionic programs that teach students to install, maintain, and repair modern airplanes have, the main verb is have. It's a complete sentence because have the opportunity to work for both airlines and government agencies. The main verb have, it's a complete meaningful sentence.
أحسنت يا دكتور. In 5 minutes, try to revise what all you have explained this episode.
Okay, on the board.
The difference, yes, yes, on the board, yes. Okay. Yes, go ahead.
The last 5 minutes for feedback for my lovely students. Today we explained sentence and fragment.
Yes.
We said that a sentence should contain a meaningful structure. It is not by elements, 1, 2, 3, not by counting number of words. I can have some kinds of sentence, it's called one word sentence, like alas, go, stop, hear, me, who. It's one word that can stand as one sentence, either interrogative like who, declarative as me, nominative like Jesse, Jean, like that. And the second element, how to build a sentence. A sentence should contain, the smallest unit should contain subject and verb, like fish, swim. Or the main sentence with us, birds, fly. Some students ask, we can see some very big sentences, large sentences, more than 2 or 3 lines. Mm-hmm. And it is called, yani, problematic for them. No. Sentence mean meaningful structure, you have to look for subject and verb. And we can build sentence by adding elements like adjective for nouns and adverb for verb and prepositional phrases like the sentence we have half an hour ago, white birds fly. This is the sentence. What's a fragment? Fragment, part of a speech that cannot indicate meaningful structure. The criterion, meaning. يبقى أنا عندي meaningful structure. يبقى أنت بتدور على the structure بتاعه. يبقى the meaningful structure عندي. This is the word you are going to look for, the criterion. When I say having shown an unusual gift. It was one of our sentences. Here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. 19 word, but still it can't stand as a mean sentence because having shown an unusual gift, Armstrong, who was one of the most famous musicians of his time, what happened? What mm-hmm. happened to him? Died in poverty. Really, he died in poverty. And the most important word, diet, mean verb. Armstrong, having shown unusual gift, having shown unusual gift, up till now it is not a sentence. Armstrong, I can delete who without adding, and it's going to be mean sentence. having shown unusual gift, Armstrong was one of the most famous musicians of his time. Either to delete who, I have two ways for changing this fragment into sentence. Either by deleting or adding. I can delete who, and it will be complete meaningful sentence. And I can keep who and add the word died in poverty or died at the age of 75, whatever. Mm-hmm. I think we have explained. Is it mm-hmm. enough? Or another example?
Another example, please.
Another example. Sally, who is known for hard work. Sally, who is known for hard work. Is it a sentence or a fragment? How can we make it a sentence if it is going to be a fragment? By adding or deleting. By both the two ways. Sally, who is known for hard work, I can. It's a fragment, by the way, because who mm-hmm. it changes the nature of the verb from main verb into to here we describe Sally. Mm-hmm. Sally, who relative pronoun. Sally, who here we use the relative pronoun who and it changes not the meaning, the nature of the verb. It won't stand as a main verb. I have to say Sally is known for hard work. Or Sally, who is known for hard work, I have to keep who. Is absent today. When you want to place and search for someone who is known for her hard work, she's absent. No one will be of the same hard work like here. I think that's enough for today.
Okay. Okay. Have a seat. Have a seat.
Okay.
يا ريت بقى في دقيقتين ثلاثة كده يعني ايه الملامح العامة بالنسبة للمنهج الأمريكي، المحتويات بتاعته، النصائح العامة اللي ممكن توجهها للطلبة بتاعته في دقيقتين ثلاثة.
أنا عاوز أقول للطلبة يعني كلمتين بجد. يعني سوري سيبكوا بقى من العصر اللي فات، خلاص بقى عفى الله عما سلف زي ما بنقول كده، نبدأ نبص لحاجة جديدة، خلاص مفيش تسريبات. مفيش الامتحانات كمان حتى الوزير قال ان الاس اي تي هيرجع يا جماعه اونلاين، يعني انت لازم تدرب نفسك ازاي تتعامل مع الكمبيوتر، ازاي تحل وانت في سكرين قدامك والسؤال بيقلب بيجي السؤال اللي بعده، احنا كنا الاول ورقي فالورقي ممكن اقوم اعمل كوبايه شاي واجي اكمل، لا الكمبيوتر مفيش الكلام ده، فلازم تتعامل مع السرعه ولازم كمان تتعامل بقى معلش مش شكوى خلاص يعني اصعب اسهل هو مش اصعب والله خالص. والله الاي سي تي مش اصعب خالص بس ربما عدد الاسئله اطول شويه لكن المعيار جواه اسهل فانا حل 70 سؤال سهل 75 بدل 44 عايزين مني تفكير والريدنج بقى هنا اكبر وهنا اصغر يعني تقريبا في بالانس في جزء زودنا فيه الريدنج شويه وجزء زودنا فيه الرايتنج شويه فالدنيا بقت ماشيه فاتمنى من الله ان انتم يعني نبدا صفحه جديده كلنا ويعني اللي حصل ده الحمد لله يكون بقى ايه يعني دافع لينا مش نفضل كده بقى نقول لا اصل لغوا الامتحان طب احنا احنا هنذاكر منهج جديد هنذاكر منهج جديد وخلال شهر واحد هيخلص المنهج على فكره
يعني مفيش اعتقد مشكلة. ان الوزير صرح من يومين ثلاثه تقريبا ان في مؤتمر هيبقى خاص بالمناهج
احنا عندنا مشكله في طلبه جريد 12 هو بسبب برضو يعني عشان ما نظلمهمش كانت الاحداث العالميه جائحه كورونا زي ما حضرتك عارف كنا من شهر 12 من ديسمبر مفيش امتحان جينا في ديسمبر الامتحان اتلغى بسبب تسريب المهم كمان اسامي المسربين دول معروفه تمام. يعني احنا نتمنى فعلا واحنا على
انا اعتقد ان هو الوزير صرح
لجنه اتحقق مع الناس دي والله بجد
تمام الوزير صرح من يومين اعتقد ان هيبقى في مؤتمر قريبا بالنسبه مؤتمر. للمدارس الدبلومات الفنيه وبالنسبه للمدارس الاجنبيه
المدارس الامريكان عشان الامتحان بقى هيبداوا يفتحوا سنترز كتيره لكل الطلبه لان في طلبه اللي هم جريد 12 دول ما امتحنوش بسبب مره تسريبات كان امتحانهم بعد كده 13 او 14 مارس تقريبا 14 اتلغى بسبب كورونا كان في امطار كمان لو نفتكر في مصر
اتلغى ولا اتاجل
لا اتلغى ما هو اتاجل جينا بعديه شهر 5 اتلغى يعني هو الطلبه بيحجزوا 6 محاولات سمستر، فطلبه اوريدي شهر 3 يعني اتلغى، فهو اوريدي الولد هيحجز 5، 5 كمان اتاجل، جينا في 6 اتاجل، وجينا في 8 بقى الاحداث الاخيره كمان 8 اتاجل قبلها اقل من 24 ساعه. هي المشكله كمان التاجيل بيجي قبل الامتحان، يعني التايم بتاعه اقل من 24 ساعه، فدي بتبقى ماساه يعني.
تمام.
يبقى الطالب خلص كتابه وداخل ينام، يجي له ايميل مفيش يا ابني امتحان، فدي صعبه.
طيب لو عايزين الطلبه بتاعتنا اللي بتتابعنا في البرنامج على مستوى الجمهوريه يتابعوا حضرتك، سواء بالنسبه للجزء اللي اتشرح او اي اجزاء
انا هنزل
أخرى
الحلقه والله في الجروبات كامله، وعلى
الرقم اللي حضرتك اللي على الشاشه ده عليه
ده
واتس،
الرقم اللي على الشاشه موجود عليه واتس، وفي رقم التاني اللي عليه واتس برضو لاخر 91. وانا عموما هنزل كل دوت، وكده كده انا النهارده عشان اشرح الحلقه دي انا سالت الطلبه يا جماعه تحبوا اشرح لكم ايه بجد، عملت استطلاع، فهم اجمعوا ان ده جزء صعب برضو مهما بيتشرح مش فاهمينه، واتمنى ان انا اكون حققت يعني ان انتوا قدرتوا تفهموا شويه، وان شاء الله المره الجايه برضو هعمل استطلاع تحبوا اكمل بايه، وبامر الله هنحل امتحانات برضو هنا، يعني كل مره هنكون يعني في حاجه افضل، وهنوصل بالطلبه ان شاء الله لبر الامان. وزي ما الوزير قال يعني اتلغى امتحان جيب ده امتحان، لكن الطالب هو الطالب، فانت اذا كنت كويس ومعيارك ان انت بتذاكر هتنجح في اي امتحان.
جميل،
بامر الله.
في اي رسائل اخيره للطلبه بتاعتك؟
اقول لهم وحشتوني بقى، والطلبه بتوع السعوديه بالذات وحشوني جدا.
بالتوفيق، شرفتينا يا دكتور،
ونتمنى
نشوفك ان شاء الله في حلقات قادمه.
بامر الله، بامر الله.
التوفيق لكل طلابنا الاعزاء على مستوى العالم.
بالتوفيق للجميع، وبالتوفيق لجميع الطلبه.
شكرا.